balloon. Little Kai liked watching wasps make their delicate nests from strips of bamboo. In AD 105, Kai gathered tiny pieces of bark, old rags, and fishing nets. He mixed them together, pressed the mixture flat, and dipped it in water. When the sheet dried, presto! Kai had invented the first piece of paper. Johannes Gutenberg. Like a new star, it shall scatter the darkness of ignorance and cause a light heretofore unknown to shine amongst men. Little Johannes lived at a time when hardly anyone had books because it took too long to write out copies by hand. Around 1439, Johannes set metal letters down in a block. Adding ink and paper, Johannes created the first printing press. He could print thousands of pages in no time. Ideas started spreading around the globe. Leonardo da Vinci. Learning never exhausts the mind. Little Leonardo was curious about everything. He watched, he measured, he wrote, he wondered. He drew plans for machines that became real hundreds of years later, like a submarine, bicycle, and helicopter. With his greatest tool, a paintbrush, Leonardo invented ways to paint that made him the most famous artist in the world. Thomas Edison. Our greatest weakness lies in giving up. The most certain way to succeed is always to try just one more time. Little Thomas was always reading and asking questions. One question was, why must I use dirty, smelly gas lamps to light my home at night? He began to tinker with light bulbs. In 1879, after hundreds of failed attempts, he finally found a way to keep one lit. Now people all over the world use electricity to see in the dark. Louis Pasteur. To know how to wonder and question is the first step toward discovery. Little Louis lived when no one really knew why people got sick. Using his microscope, he looked and looked and looked for the answer. Finally, Louis discovered something no one else could see: germs. He found that if you boiled the germs, they went away. In 1885, Louis learned that germs could protect people too. Since then, Louis's vaccines have saved millions of lives. Curie. Nothing in life is to be feared. It is only to be understood. Little Marie loved to study elements, materials that come from the earth. She tested a special rock until she found a strange glowing blue light. What could it be? Marie had discovered a brand new element, radium. Doctors soon found that radium could fight off deadly cancers. In 1903, Marie was the first woman to ever win a Nobel Prize. The Wright Brothers. Isn't it astonishing that all these secrets have been preserved for so many years, just so we could discover them? Little Wilbur and Orville were brothers who liked to tinker with machines. One day, their father brought home a toy helicopter that flew. They wanted to fly too. They studied the wings, the tail, and everything they needed to know about flight. Crashing never discouraged them for long. Finally, in 1903, they flew the first airplane. Grace Murray Hopper. If you've got a good idea and you know it's going to work, go ahead and do it. Little Grace loved learning about math, science, and cool gadgets. Once, she took apart 7 alarm clocks just to see how the gears worked. When she got older, Grace figured out how to program a room-sized computer to respond to human language, not just number codes. Now people all over the world can use computers every day. These heroes imagined and invented a better world. What kind of hero will you be?
Artist, today you are about to become an inventor and create a homework machine. So this project was inspired by a poem from the book A Light in the Attic by Shel Silverstein. The homework machine, oh the homework machine, most perfect contraption that's ever been seen. Just put in your homework, then drop in a dime, snap on the switch, and in 10 seconds time, your homework comes out quick and clean as can be. Here it is, 9 plus 4, and the answer is 3. 3? Oh me, I guess it's not as perfect as I thought it would be. Artist, I love this poem. I think it is so silly, and I also adore this illustration. Inside of this homework machine is a small drawing of a person who is actually the brain of the machine that's doing the homework, and I thought that was so creative. I am so excited to see what would you guys create if you could invent your own homework machine. For today's project, you're going to create your homework machine on a white sheet of paper using pencil, Sharpie, and then some coloring materials. So markers or colored pencils or crayons would all work fantastic for the coloring step of this assignment. Your first job is going to be to decide, do you want your homework machine to be drawn on your paper landscape or portrait style? Either is absolutely fine. You're going to use pencil to start your sketch. You'll outline in Sharpie, then add color. Now for my project example, I am using my pencil and I'm just sketching out my own version of a homework machine, and I wanted to walk you through the process and talk about some different elements that I want you to consider as you're creating your own invention. So first up, what is the shape of your machine? This could literally be anything that you can come up with. How does your homework get inputted into the machine? Is there a slot or is there a certain area where you would punch in the information? Do you have a start button? Do you have a lever? How is it controlled? Is it electronic or is it run by maybe solar power? Is it plugged into the wall? You decide. What type of information is written on your homework machine? Is there any type of gauges? What about where the homework pops out when it's done? Do you have some type of area where you would grab your finished piece? And last but not least, taking inspiration from our drawing in the book, who does the homework inside of your contraption? Is it a computer or is there an actual person? For mine, I decided that I was going to train butterflies, and that's right, butterflies are doing all of my homework inside of my machine. So right here, I'm drawing a viewing window so the viewer can see the homework being completed by a bunch of very well-trained butterflies. Now, artists, as you can tell, this invention is pretty creative, and you're welcome to take it as far as you would like as you're creating your own drawing. Now on my machine, I'm also giving it a title at the top and I'm writing homework machine. I'm abbreviating homework to be just HW. Now you can put a name on your machine as well. This is your choice as an artist and I want you guys to be as creative as possible as you are becoming an inventor today. So you're gonna start with pencil, outline in Sharpie, and then your last step is to add color to accentuate your work. You are welcome to mix mediums, which means maybe a combination of two or three different coloring items, or you can use just one type of coloring item. This is totally your choice as an artist of how you want to complete this piece. I'm using a combination of markers and colored pencils, and I'm going around and thinking about what my materials are made out of for my homework machine. So I have a lot of metal, and then I just have bright colors because I love all the colors of the rainbow. So my homework machine would be very colorful and very bright. So these are details I'm incorporating. My artist, you guys can take it wherever you would like today. I am so excited to see what you come up with, how your machine works, and what other details you're going to incorporate as you tackle this project.